Let's face it, my 3-year-old e-bike is about to die because its battery is going to die. It can't hold charge anymore. Needless to say, it's time for a replacement. This bike runs at 60 volt, which means we are dealing with 5 12 volt batteries in series. So we have to replace all the 5 of them. Maybe one of these batteries is still doing well, but changing the complete set is always a good decision. So without further ado, let's disassemble the bike and replace all of them to put a fresh new life into my ride. Let's get started. Frankly speaking, replacing the batteries is not a hard job to do, but it is time consuming. Before we are tinkering with the bike, let's discuss some basics about the batteries. Here we are dealing with 5 12 volt batteries in series. Means 60 volt in total. All the batteries are 28 ampere hour. As everything in series, so the battery voltage and current are 60 volt 28 ampere hour. Elementary, right? Anyway, let's come on the bike. First, we need to put my ride into its main stand. Don't forget it, never use the side stand in this type of operation. If your bike is on charge, unplug it and make sure the key is on the off position. The battery compartment of my electric bike is under the seat, so we need to open it first. This seat consists of 4 screws in total, so we have to remove it. You can use a 4-head screwdriver or a 10mm socket wrench or 10mm nut driver bit like mine to remove it. After lifting the seat up, we have the access to all the 5 batteries. But wait, before touching anything, we have to open the breaker or you can say MCB for safety. After a bit of cleaning, we need to unmount this portion to get full access to all the 5 batteries. For that, just remove these 3 screws and pull this cover upward to take it out from its cavity. For this model, the charging port is also placed here. So we have to disconnect it from the bike to completely remove this cover. After disconnecting the charging connector, we have to disconnect the battery positive and negative terminal from the bike, which is obviously quite an easy job to do. Just remove the lid of this connector and unscrew this screw to completely disconnect it. Anyway, to pull out these batteries, first we need to open this bracket by removing this nut. So I have again used a 10mm nut driver bit with my drill to remove it. Afterward, I just take out the bracket carefully to not to short the batteries or not to lose this metal part either. This piece is actually broken from the battery compartment body, which will not create any problem because this bracket creates lots of pressure on the batteries to tighten them in place. Now we need to remove the wirings between the batteries to take them out one by one. Don't get confused, these batteries are in series. These wires are used to take them in series configuration. Now all the batteries are free, but we can't take them out from the compartment easily because there is no grip to hold them. So I have used the jumper wires to take them out. I set the wires with the battery terminal and by holding the wires, I pulled out the batteries from its chamber. Although this process is a bit risky for the wires, they will break internally, but who cares? These are the batteries which came with the bike. These are 12 volt 24 ampere hour. And what I am using as a replacement, it's 12 volt 28 ampere hour, which doesn't create any problem, but the downside is their physical dimension is quite a bit big. This is not a big deal though, but it's better to clear everything. This extra power obviously comes in handy. We will get some extra travel distance from my ride, which is obviously a plus. Anyway, after taking out all the 5 batteries, I have cleaned the compartment a bit and started to place the new batteries one by one. Battery positions are important here, so follow me. It's important that if your bike's battery compartment configuration is like me, then better to place battery in the downstairs first, then on the upstairs. Otherwise, you will face a bad day. Just kidding, the fitting will be very difficult for you. Either way, let's wiring them up to achieve the required voltage. Be careful with this setup. If you have done something wrong, the whole system will be on fire. And always double check and triple check the wirings And finally, it's better to test the voltage with the multimeter. Now I am getting around 60 volt in total. Although the meter is showing 64 volt because the batteries are fully charged. So everything is fine, nothing to worry about. Then I have placed two cardboard pieces on two sides of the battery. This will prevent the battery movement inside the chamber. Anyway, it's time to connect the battery with my bike. After connecting the battery positive and negative terminal and tighten their screws, I have turned on the MCB, rotated the key and waited for the best. Thankfully, it starts instantly and through the display, it shows me all the readings that come in handy during the ride. So to take this project to the end, I have simply turned off the MCB and started to fit the holding bracket in place. After tightening the screw, I have managed the cardboard piece to slide under the bracket and started to place the cover into its position. Fitting this part is not quite easy. There are a lot of clips here and there. Be careful, they are pretty fragile too. Next, we need to place this bent-like plastic piece into this place. It also consists of some clips to fit itself inside. To hold everything in tight, there are some screws that would be pretty helpful too. After connecting this connector in place, which is responsible for the charging, this project becomes almost completed. Now put the seat back on, insert all the four screws in place and tighten them up. And that's it. The bike is ready to ride. So I turn on the MCB, rotate the key and take my bike to a long ride. Just joking, don't get around guys, stay home and stay safe. I just tested it in my compound, which gets me satisfied obviously. New battery means new power, so I successfully provide a new soul into my ride. Therefore, this small yet memorable project is completed. Hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If so, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe and turn on the notification bell for future updates. Thank you so much.